Morning, guys. It's Saturday, December 31st, New Year's Eve. There's a little bit of stuff in the dump truck that I've been meaning to do for a long, long time, but I've yet to do. Still needs clean, but it's really cold and it's just gonna freeze on it. So I'm gonna wait until it's a little bit warmer so I can clean it off real good. I'll wait on the glow plugs. This time of year, it takes a little while. Okay, so we're gonna finally mount this plow controller. I got some double stick tape that can hold 30 pounds, and I'm gonna stick that on this. There we go. So hold 30 pounds, huh? No. Okay, so this one's sticking real well. This one, not so much. But even so, it's up. If it falls, I'll Velcro it. Now for the plow controller. I don't like joystick controllers. I think that the remote is far superior, and I'll show you why. And unless you mount this on the seat back here somewhere, which is not long enough to do, you're leaning forward, reaching on this the whole time. Whereas, we'll go over and demonstrate in the other pickup. Whereas in this one, you got the remote in your hand. You can sit it on your lap. You can have it in your hand while you're shifting. You don't even have to look at it. You can feel and hit the remote. It's not a bad remote. Up, down, and scoop and retract are basically the only ones you use on the V-plow. And left and right, some. At least that's the only ones I used. It's not hard to get a hang of at all. And you can put it wherever you feel like putting your arm. You don't have to keep your arm up on the dash. Leaning forward, reaching forward, it gets uncomfortable quickly. You can put it wherever you feel like using it. So I want to get one for the dumpy here. Nice diesel smell. So I want to put one on Dumpy and see how that goes. But once again, like a lot of other things I've wanted to do, I haven't done it yet. Okay, so we got everything mounted. I re-ran this one with 3 strips running across because it didn't stick the first time. I heated it up on the heater real good. It's pretty cold. I think that's why it didn't stick. That, and I don't buy that it holds 30 pounds. That's not true, because it barely holds that. Maybe on a correct surface, but that isn't the correct surface. So we got that going. Got this mounted. Got enough clearance on the turn signal. Truck needs washed off. Oh, and I picked up another snow account. I'll tell you about that in a second. See, yeah, this thing needs washed very badly. That's all pure salt sitting on it from the roads. Okay, anyway. So I'm subcontracting with a guy on Gold's Gym that we plow. Basically, he does the mowing. He does not do any snow removal. So he called me and was like, hey, you think you can swing a property? So I'm like, sure. Went out, gave the bid. Essentially,
I'm subcontracting, but in reality, I am the main contractor there. He does not have a contract with them for snow. He does not have anything with them. Basically, he's getting a little cut because he gave me their phone number and set everything up. But it is, the contract is not between him and I. It's between them and me. So that happened. That was a good property, so I went with it. And I got a call just the day before yesterday for a little doctor office. So I'm like, okay. It was through him again. So I'm like, okay, I'll take it. Very, very small. I go out, meet with the property, well, with the actual doctor, like probably the owner, I'm assuming. And she explains to me that she is extremely particular. The storm where I was plowing Thursday, I posted the video Friday. For the person that commented they must have money to burn, yeah, she fired the contractor because they did not plow that storm. And they didn't salt it. So she went out and fired him. That's the kind of customer I like. I like the customers that, literally, if there is a millimeter of snow, she wants salt. If there is an inch, it's getting plowed. Anything under that, anything under an inch, you salt it. If you can plow it under an inch, go ahead and plow it. That's the type of customer I like. Not afraid to spend their money on little storms. So, oh, one second here. It's my little vlog for today. It's going to actually be the last video of 2016. And this 2016 was a freaking amazing year. I still, tomorrow, the first day of 2017, January 1st, still crazy to me. I'm going to post a throwback to the biggest project I did in 2016. I had talked about doing a best and worst video, but I could probably come up with a best video. I really don't have that much of the worst. Because that project, the biggest project I did, that project went south so many different ways. It still came out really good in the end. But it was the most stressful week of the year for sure. So many things went wrong, it wasn't even funny. But I didn't record over probably 3/4 of the stuff that happened, I did not record. I don't know if it was as that I didn't want the YouTube audience to know about it, that I just wasn't really thinking about recording. Because I actually was daily uploading during that, because I was getting enough footage. So I don't really know what the story was with that. But I'm going to do a throwback to that. And just put all the videos together and let you guys see kind of the general size of that job. That thing was big. I'll give you a little hint here. 50 triaxles of topsoil parked around a foundation driveway, square foundation. It's about 8 feet. The ground level is about 8 feet below it. The entire foundation needs filled in. I still don't know what the heck he was going to do with it. So he trucked in at least 50 piles of dirt. Go in, spread that out in about 6 hours with a Bobcat T750. That machine was awesome. Dirt didn't take long at all. Well, we come to find out all that dirt that was supposedly enough was a good bit short. So that was the start to the project. So I came out and gave him a rate. Well, actually, he gave me the rate. He said someone else was doing it for X amount. Will you do it for that? And I'm like, sure. Because it's an excellent learning experience for me. All, everything's there. All I'm doing is supplying the machine and the labor. So I go out, do the estimate in the pouring down rain. The dude's Indian, hard to understand. We're also excavating both sides of the driveway. His driveway's over 1,000 feet long. And putting in a stone pad along beside it. I still think to this day that he initially, when we looked at it, told me it was like a car length long. I didn't quite understand what he was doing. So I thought I knew. So when I get out there with the machine, he's like, no. You see that cone up there? I'm like, what cone? He's like, the cone, for example, the fourth house up there. I'm like, what? He's like, yeah, you're digging up to there. I'm like, what? I was not happy. I'm like, I did not know that. That's why I'm like, okay, at least I'm not paying material. So what I was under the impression, all we needed, because he told me, oh, we'll need about a truckload of stone. I'm like, okay, not a big deal. The dirt's here. We'll need a truckload of stone for on top the patio. Little bits on the edge is here. We're good to go. Be in and out maybe 2-3 days. So I do that. Get all the dirt graded out in the first about day. It's about as good as it's going to get. The patio pit is still completely unfull. There's still about foot edges up to the... Well, I was doing both. I was dumping in and then putting out on the outside. That way I didn't collapse the wall. So there was about maybe... It was full along the edge, but in the middle, it was still completely empty. So maybe 20% of it was full. The outside still needed some dirt. So I'm like, okay, he's going to have to truck in more. Great. That's more work that I did not account for. So instead of, we dig all the dirt out from the along the driveway. That gets put over there, and that was about probably equivalent to 4 or 5 dump truck traxle loads. I ended up using the skid steer just to truck it because I didn't have my dump truck at the time. And the dump trailers suck. And I had one, when they were delivering stone, I had the driver let me load him up with the Bobcat, and he transported it over. So after that, he orders 5 22.5-ton triaxle loads of 2A modify and 4 or 5 triaxle loads of 2B. The 2B went in the patio pit. For whatever reason, he ordered 2B. I was not in on that. He was doing all the ordering. He was doing all the supplies. I was not even concerned about that. So the 2A went along the driveway. The 2B went in the patio. What ended up being a week-long project. Well, 8-day-long project. Solid, 8-day solid. We broke a door off a dump trailer. Bob Thatch on the Bobcat blew a hydraulic line. My fault snapped the hydraulic line on a sweeper broom because I used the Bob Thatch. Forgot about the hydraulic line. Didn't see it and backed away from it. Completely my fault. Completely my fault. Broke that. Okay, that cost me almost $400 to repair, to get fixed. So that was the first crap. The dump trailer cost about $40. Not a big deal. So then I have a grader, 6B landscape rake. I tied them up with bungee cord. Made sure they were completely away from the tracks because the hydraulic lines were long. And they were dangling like this close to the track. I'm like, they're going to get run over. So I'm doing the project. About halfway through, they're grading. Customer comes yelling, no, stop, stop, stop. I'm like, don't know what he's talking about. And it's too late. All of a sudden, the windshield is covered in something. I'm like, did it just start raining? No, it didn't start raining. You just ran over your hydraulic line and ripped it off. And broke the quick connector on the machine. After that, I'm like, this is ridiculous. I tied it up. I admit the other time that was completely my fault. That was not my fault. Your hydraulic lines are too long. You delivered the machine that way. I even made sure. I took pictures of it too because I was nervous about that. They only billed me for parts. Before they made a brand new hydraulic line. Brand new 6-foot long hydraulic line. 2 of them this big around. Instead they just snipped the ends off and put new ends on it. Called it good. Billed me like $50. So. That wasn't too bad. But that was the project. It was an extreme headache. I'm 8-9 minutes into this video, so I gotta wrap it up. You'll see that on tomorrow's video. So thanks for watching.